Hello again. Here we will take the input from microphone and output it as text. To do that, we need speech recognition and also Pi Audio modules. Before installing those modules, one side note, if you are using Python 3.7, at the time of this recording, Pi Audio did not have official support for Python 3.7, which means that it will throw an error at installation asking for Microsoft Visual C++ 14. To solve this problem, I will present here two options. The first one is going to this website and a list of wheels will appear for you to download, okay? After download, open a PowerShell in the same directory of the downloaded file and type pip install and the file name. For my machine, the right one was this one. For yours, it can be another, okay? This option allows us to use Python 3.7, but remember, if something goes wrong, you will not find an easy answer because you have no support, at least yet, okay? The option 2 is download and install Python 3.6 in another folder, and because Python 3.7 or other version that you must have is the main one, the symbols Python, Pi and pip will be pointing for Python 3.7 or your version. So to solve that problem, we need to create an alias in PowerShell like this. We type set alias and then we type the alias that we pretend. In this case is Python 36. Then we type the path for the file that we want the alias refer to. In this case, the Python 36 is referring to the executable that is at C Python 36 and is called python.exe. Also, we need to create alias for Pi and for pip. So with this, the symbol Python, Pi and pip still remain for Python 3.7. Every time that we type Python 36 or Pi 36 or pip 36, it will refer always to Python 3.6. After everything, we can pip install speech recognition and after that pip install Pi audio, okay? You should have no problems with this. And now we can do our code. As always, the first thing that we need to do is import. Import what? The speech recognition as SR. Then we need to get an object that will analyze the sound. And that object is the recognizer. So rec is equals to SR.recognizer. Okay. And now we can start listening from microphone. We type with SR.microphone as mic. We inform the user that he is being listened, so print you can start talking now. We get the audio from the microphone. To do that, we say audio is equals to recognizer dot listen to the mic, and at the end we inform the user that time is over, like this. And now we can start recognize. To do that, we go here, let me give more space for us, and we try print the text that we get from recognizer dot recognize, and here we have several options. We have the recognize underscore Bing, we have the recognize underscore Google and other sources. I will use for this Google. Okay, recognize underscore Google, and we provide what we just listened the audio, okay, just like this. This can throw an exception, so we need a accept, and we will inform the user that it just exploded. Okay, and now we can test this. We open the console, and first I will use with Python 3.7, so Pi speech to text. You can start talking now, please say something like what I am doing right now. Time is over. And the text is, you can start talking now, please say something like what I am doing right now, is what I just said. And to use the Python 3.6, I have here the alias to copy. I copy here this and go here to the terminal and paste here the alias, okay? And while I have the terminal opened, these alias are okay, but if I close the terminal, these alias are forgotten, okay? If you want to make these permanent, you must create a profile in PowerShell, okay? And now let's try with Python 3.6, so py 3.6 and speech to text. If you find this video helpful, please give it a like. Time is over, and the result is, if you find this video helpful, please give it a like. Don't forget that you can download the source code, the link is in the description of the video. If you want to help me, give a like to this video, and as always, thank you for watching.